أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم The year is 610 AD The day is 10th of August The day Monday A 4-year-old man of faith sits in a cave in seclusion and meditation An angel was it delivered the message of highest authority to him The first words of the message are Iqra bismi rabbika allazi khalaq Read in the name of your Lord who created you Mr. President, the very first message from Allah was instruction for humanity to attend education and in religion, your religion, our religion, Islam, all about tolerance. Have you forgotten the pagans' practice of burning their daughters? Who abolished their tradition? Mr. President, who? We did it because we were educated as per the instruction from our Lord. How can anyone say that education aims are nothing beside tolerance? Helen Keller says, and I quote, The highest result of education is tolerance. To comprehend the meaning of tolerance, we can have to look into society, where we can grow, learn, and interact with others. The ratio of tolerance is way down. People have become frustrated, confused, and short-tempered. We have started believing in shortcuts, and what everything is jeopardy. Dear listeners, our system of education needs an overhaul under the influence of present commercial education system. This sector has become an industry, a real profitable industry, where people invested for their materialistic gains, ignoring the foundation of all character buildings. If it continues, Mr. President, if it continues growing like that, then we will become dead. Dead dummies have no beliefs, no values, no norms, no care of contrast, and finally no identity at all. What's happening in Karachi, Quetta, Dera Ismail Khan? Have you forgotten the recent incident in Khanpur? Can you forget the 2 years girl was chatted by family members? Mr. President, does this education system aims at developing of our tolerance? Can we compare ourselves with our own strong? I think we cannot, because we are the product of this business-oriented platforms. Mr. President, I would like to remind you with the words of Napoleon when he said, Give me a good mother, I will give you a good nation. By good mother, he meant nothing than more than educated women. Then let me rephrase these words to make the message clear. Give my people education and I will give you a tolerance nation. When you and I came to this world as nothing than more than black chambers were the established of time. The established runs tight the accumulation of learning. This was our education. Mr. President, at this point let me make very clear that by education I ever meant to limit the academic pursuit of excellence that we carry at our schools and universities. Education is material that goes every aspect of our life and aims at developing tolerance. It goes beyond the walls of Mr. President, education defines the person, his mental capacity and how he behaves with the world of large. Mr. President, have you forgotten the Salahuddin Ayyubi? Yes, he was a tolerant leader. Despite his ambassadors still at the hands of fools, he forgave them. Mr. President, have you forgotten the tolerance of our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? He Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the embodiment of tolerance. Despite the option of dying forever, he chose to pray for them. Mr. President, did he not? I would like to remind you with the words of some God. Education is not preparation for the life, but education is the life for itself. Thanks.